Even on the clearest night, the human eye can only see about 3,000 stars in the sky. But there are an estimated 100 billion stars in our galaxy alone, and NASA says that there are quite possibly 500 billion galaxies floating around out there. When you look at Andromeda, which is our closest galactic neighbor, it is 2.3 million light years away, which means that the time for the light to get to us would take 2.3 million years for that light from Andromeda to reach us here on planet Earth. And if God created the universe 6,000 years ago, as I believe he did personally, then the light that you are seeing from Andromeda actually comes from the mind of God as he stretched out the heavens above us, as it says in the psalm that I read earlier. If you could travel at 100,000 miles per hour, or at the speed of light, which is 186,000 miles per hour, it would take 100,000 years just across our one galaxy. And God saw that it was good. So the evening and the morning were the fourth day. Thus ends the first Wednesday on planet Earth. And all of this majesty was placed in the heavens and on the earth by an infinitely intelligent and loving creator. But something happened not too long after creation, and it has put a divide between us and God. And that is when sin entered the stream of mankind, when Adam rebelled against God. And so I'd like to take just a moment, and if anybody here has never heard the gospel of Jesus Christ, I would like to give that to you. There is a rift between us and God. Every one of us, if we are truly honest with ourselves, has sinned. We've either told a lie, or we've thought some wicked thought about another person. Whatever, it is sin. It separates us from God. And what God did is he sent his son, Jesus Christ, to live the perfect life that we cannot live. The same God that spoke this universe into existence sent his son in the form of man to live that life and then to give his own life up as a ransom for ours. And if we simply call on the name of Jesus Christ by faith, God promises that just as he created the universe by the breath of his mouth, he will also redeem us and he will give us everlasting life by faith in the deeds of Jesus Christ. So the Bible says that we have all sinned, we all fall short of the glory of God, but that we can be reconciled through Jesus' atoning sacrifice. And the gift of God is eternal life through him. So I would ask, if you have never asked Jesus Christ to be your personal Lord and Savior, if you want to talk about that more after the sermon, come on up to me and we'll talk about it. But God sent his own son into the world for you and for me.